Hello everybody and welcome to Dark Tries. And today I'm doing a bit of a special one because I'm going to be driving one of the most unique Black Fives in preservation. This, the LMS Black Five, number 44767, George Stephenson. Now why am I excited about this pack that's just been released by Bossman Games? Because George Stephenson, the locomotive, is incredibly unique and it's a bit of a celebrity in preservation. Now you might be looking at it and thinking, oh, there's nothing much different about this. Well, just from the front you can see already it's got electric headlamps. This is obviously preserved condition. This engine was built in 1947 on the last day of the LMS in December 31st, 1947. Obviously it's a Stanley design but modified by H.G. Ivatt. With one major thing, because I've just mentioned the electric lighting, one of the main reasons why this thing is so unique in preservation is this, the valve gear. This has Stephenson outside link motion valve gear, and it just looks so weird and complex, and I love it a lot. It was sort of weird, because I'm pretty sure this was some sort of challenge, which was, oh, can we fit Stephenson's outside motion onto an engine, and this is the result. Not really much else to say. It was originally fitted with a double chimney, but in preservation it has a single chimney. This is the only Black Five we've actually seen modelled in game with a forward top feed, so that's nice to see. It's got all the gizmos and things. It's even got ATC, I believe. So we're going to give it a little run on the DR. And yeah, that's really it, really. One of the major things as well is it's got roller bearings. As oh god, my camera is so bad, I'm really sorry. But over here on the tender, you can see them on the outside of the tender. You've got the Timken roller bearings. So that's pretty good. It's got roller bearings all around. Riveted tender. And it's pretty much the same as the other Black Five. I've just given it a very small test run before I started recording this video. And the sounds are the same, obviously, because it's a Black Five. I didn't know whether there was a different chuff sound with the Stephenson valve gear, whether it gives a different sound to the exhaust. But I'd imagine it isn't. It's negligible at best. So we are going to give this, I mean, this is only going to be a quick dark try because this is an add-on released by Bossman Games. It's $6.99 on their store and you have to have the Bossman Game Black 5 in order to obviously use it because I think a lot of things are shared between the two packs. The other thing I'm going to say is that it comes with four variations of George Stephenson. The one I'm driving right now is the what you would maybe term as the default one, because it's got the black fronted number plate, but you get a red backed number plate, a blue backed number plate, and a white bordered number plate. I'm going to be probably doing some experimentation with this, because I want to see whether you can take that nameplate off. You might not be able to, but we'll give it a shot, because that would be pretty cool to see it in its sort of like, you know, BR era days, because it was not named George Stephenson until preservation. So, I'm sorry by the way, I've got a bit of a cold, but I was really excited. As soon as I saw this, I rushed home and bought it, because I love George Stephenson. I love the valve gear. I love how unique it is among Black Fives. I mean, obviously, it'd be nice to see the Caprotti Black Five modelled in TS. I'm hoping that Bossman will do that. But, as it is, at the moment we've got this. So, other thing to mention, as with the normal Black Five, if I just click on it, unless I've already clicked on it. I think I might have already clicked on it. Let's try. No, I haven't clicked on it yet. As with the other Bossman Game Black Fives, it's got the usual good standard. It's got its own custom cab view with the AWS ATC. You've got your firebox, 3D firebox. That's pretty cool. Obviously, you've got the camber views as well, and you've also got all these outside ones. I know it still hasn't fixed the issue with the wheels not showing in the cab views, but it doesn't matter. But now we've got this, which is that when it comes over the sand covers, you've now got the George Stephenson nameplate and the little plaque underneath it. So that's pretty nice to see that it's in like literally the best place it could be on the cab views. You've also got, as with the other Black Fives, you've got an opening smoke box door. That's pretty good as well. Unfortunately, still no custom shed plates, I don't think. And we go along the other side of the boiler, and you've got the other cover there. And we're back to the cab. So, they're the cab views. I've already tried to look and see whether the valve gear actually animates. I'm not sure whether it does, so we're going to put it into full forward and then full reverse. Because I know on the normal Black Fives, it does animate. So, if we try and put it into reverse, which we are, the valve gear doesn't move. I can imagine why, because it's probably very complex. This valve gear is pretty complex compared to Wall Shark's valve gear. So, yeah, it doesn't animate when you're on standstill. But that doesn't matter, because, well, you'll see when we're on the move. So, without further ado, let's pick up some coaches, and we're going to go for a little run over to Hitch and Abbas. I'll turn the sounds up, as I usually do, on my dark tries, so here we go, I guess. Let's see, I'm going to turn the sounds up and turn myself down, so, let's go. Turn the sound back down. So I noticed that I've accidentally managed to somehow put the headboard on the tender as we rolled out there. I'm just trying some keyboard controls just to see whether I could change that. I'm pretty sure that's easily done. I'm trying Control-Shift-H, Control-H, Control-Shift-5, Control-5. That does that lamp. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that you've got different lamp settings for this loco. How did I do that? Might have been... No, wasn't that. Doesn't matter. I'll work it out at some point. So, as I say, we're going to have a run. I love the animation on the valve gear, I must say. It's just very hypnotising, and it's just so nice to finally have George Stephenson in-game. Bossman have done a cracking job. I think their Black Fives are probably the best things they've done, because I was a bit indifferent to the S15, I must admit. But... And Black Five is like my favourite things in the entire world. Well, I'm just incredibly happy with this, and I'm incredibly happy with how this loco looks and how it's come out. Would have been nice to see it in LMS livery, but I'm pretty sure that some talented reskinners, I might even try it myself if I can, well, if I can get the act up to do it. I even want to try and reskin it into DR Green, so we'll have a look into that at some point, maybe. But for now, we're going to go and have a run down to Hitch and Abbas over from Barbour North as I was building in my stream the other night. So, without further ado, I'm going to put the reverser back to forward. I'm going to shut my trap and we're going to listen. But I will point out just before we go though, if you do control, I think control 4 I'm doing. Or the control shift 4. And control 4 controls the headlamp at the top. So you see control 3 does these lamps here, like you can have the normal head code, running in reverse head code, high intensity headlamp, or main line being toe dead one. And you can do that on all of the bottom three. I'm not sure you can do it on the top one though. So anyway, without further ado, let's stick a high intensity headlamp there for lols. Let's stick a lamp on the top. That was not what I wanted to do. There we go. And I will shut up and we shall drive George Stephenson. So I'll give my views a bit more in a minute when we get to Hitchin' Alice.
Thank you.
So, it's time for that all-important question. Would I recommend getting the Bossman Game Black 5 44767 add-on? That depends. If you really, really like the fact, like if you followed the history of Black 5s, and if you really enjoy the fact that this has got a different valve gear, and it's got the George Stephenson nameplate, and it's another preserved Black 5 to add to our list of locos that are represented in game properly, I would definitely recommend it. If you're a casual driver and you've already got the Black 5s, I'd say this is a good add-on to add to your collection, but I'm not saying push to get it. What I'm saying is, if you really, really like it, and hopefully this video will show you what it's like, get it. If you really like the valve gear and you like the history of the locomotive and the fact it's got the working headlamps and headboards, I'm not sure if I showed the headboards, but it has got a load of headboards, so I'm just going to quickly come back to the front before we leave and show you that. If you press H, it gives you a bunch of different headboards, so Jacobite, Great Britain, Regional Express, Cumbrian Mountain, I-1T57, North Wales Coast Express, Welsh Marches, and that's it. So what you get is quite a lot of headboards as well. So you get the new headboards, you get the high intensity headlamps, you get the valve gear, you get the nameplate, and four different variations with the front end. So would I recommend it? Again, if you like Black 5s, absolutely. If you've already got the base Black 5, I'd recommend getting this one when you can, because it's a nice little drive and I love Black 5s. I just can't tell you enough how happy I am to have this add-on. So without further ado, we're going to watch George leave and I'm going to go do something else. So thank you everybody for watching. I'm going to turn the sound back up and I will speak to you all next time. Goodbye.